joined by Hofstra coach Joe Mihalik, senior Rokas Gustis, and junior Justin Wright Foreman. Coach, an opening statement about tonight's game.
Well, that was a fabulous win, and the reason why is because we should have lost. I mean, that game had loss written all over it, and we found a way to win. You know, the discussion in the locker room right there was about, real basically as could be, how hard it is to win a college basketball game. How hard it is to win a college basketball game. You got to be ready to go. Everybody's good this day and age. Time was when three teams in the league wouldn't even show up, and that was six wins for you on the schedule. Not like that anymore. Everybody's talented, everybody's good, and everybody's playing hard. So, you know, we could have lost that game. We didn't. We found a way. I'm really proud of our guys. There's a lot of things we were bad at. I mean, 20 turnovers is just, there's a lot of things we were bad at. But I'll tell you what we were good at, finding a way to win a game that we should have lost.
Questions?
Justin, you just described the play with 1.1 seconds left in regulation. You guys tied it up.
Well, I knew my coach did a great job of drawing a play. I mean, you work on it every day in practice, and, you know, it worked here and there, but, you know, in the game, you know, it paid off. So, I mean.
Justin, I think that's the most frustrated that I've ever seen you on a full court during your time. What were those emotions sort of like earlier in the game when you were struggling a bit, and then how did you turn that around to, you know, have the night that you did?
The frustration was really with myself. I wasn't really hitting shots in the beginning, but then I realized that was kind of selfish of me. So I just tried to pick myself up and just be more positive about the situation, because shots are gonna fall. I'm a scorer, so I just gotta keep shooting. And my teammates gave me great confidence, told me to keep shooting the ball, and so did the coaches, so that's what I kept doing.
Coach Enroch, this is for you about him. You know, it seemed like when the game was on the line, you know, he wanted the ball and he did something with it. What does it say about a teammate or a player when he takes kind of the game in his hands? What did you think?
Well, but I would just say this: every team probably has a go-to guy, and you know, anybody can study our team, watch our team, and realize that Justin's a gifted scorer. You know, I think he has six assists tonight. I think he's become a lot better passing the basketball. Now, you know, he's going to, much like everybody else, look at those turnovers and not be proud of them, but. You know, when you can, I think he's getting better and better at making plays for other people. I actually think he gets the ball to Rock better than anybody. So he's doing a much better job of not just being a scorer, doing the other things, but sure. I mean, that's not to be a master of the obvious. He's our go-to guy. That's what it is.
What do you think of the way he performed?
We trust him, you know, like everybody knows it's going to be ball in Justin's hands, and, you know, we believe him. He hit shots before like that. Last year, I remember, directs at home. I didn't play, and he hit that big shot. You know, we just believe in him. You know, he's really good in situations like that.
He assisted on your. Were you aware of how close you were to 1,000 points? Were you aware of the moment?
Yeah, I mean, not gonna lie. So yeah, I knew it was 10 points.
Well, I don't mean to break in here, but I actually talked to Rock about that today. I said, look, everybody knows you need 10 points. I said, we're not gonna run five plays in a row for you just so you can get an easy layup. We're not gonna let your basket hang five times in a row. You're gonna get it. Enjoy the moment when it happens, but just let it come naturally and play hard. You've already basically rewritten the record books at Hofstra. The next step is here to get this team to win as many games as possible, and the ultimate dream, get in the NCAA tournament.
What was it like to get to reach that milestone?
Like I said, the coach makes me feel old, but besides that, you know, I'm glad that we won. You know, that's the most important thing. It doesn't matter if you lose and I get the 1,000, you know, no one's going to talk about it, no one's going to want it to know about it, you know, so. It's just nice what we won, and, you know, 1,000 is just, it's good.
So how many Hofstra players have 1,000 points and 1,000 rebounds?
Three.
Okay. I know John Irving did it. Who am I forgetting?
Bill Thiel.
Oh, with it.
Joe, Justin had 8 points at the 8-minute timeout in the second half. Ends up with 26, hits the overtime portion shot. I mean, is this like a Wanya Green-esque effort tonight, or where he puts you on your back, or an effort, some of the best players you've had, where a guy just puts him on your back? I know we talked about him being your go-to guy, but, you know, at crunch time, just puts him on the back, and he hasn't been a great game before that.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's always about the next play. And if he would have thought about the last, let me do my math right here, 32 minutes. If he'd have thought about the previous 32 minutes, he wouldn't have been able to perform successfully the last 8. So that's a credit to his poise, a credit to his confidence as always, and he just knew that if he just kept his head together, he could score some points. Now, that's a pretty impressive number there. So he ends up with, so that's 18 points right in 13 minutes. Pretty good.
Justin, what is it like to be the go-to guy? I know it's an honor, but there's also a lot of pressure on it. How were you feeling?
I wouldn't say it's a lot of pressure because I was like that in high school, but I mean, obviously it's a lot different. It just comes down to my teammates trusting me as long as the coaching staff, but I just have to make plays for other people as well as being a coaching guy.
Joe, what do you think of Jalen Ray's night and the progress he's made this year, 5-9 with a career high 18?
Yeah, that's his career high? I thought he had about that against Monmouth.
17.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah, I mean, he's a confident guy as well. He's got a little Justin in him. You know, he's getting more of a chance. I mean, if the coach would have played Justin more a lot when he was a freshman, he would have, you know. But, you know, Jalen's taking advantage of his opportunities, and he's, you know, like I just told the team, if you produce, you're going to stay on the floor. If you don't, I got to put somebody else in that's going to do it.
Be remiss if I don't ask you about, you know, Mosley had a terrific game. What'd you think of what he did?
When he fouled out,
both sides of the
when he fouled out, I said that's the only way we're going to stop him because he's now out of the game. This is the only time I feel like we're going to stop him because he's sitting on the bench.
So. Coach, how about the play of your big men? Obviously, Rock 12-18, but Hunter 8 points in the 10 minutes that he played, and Mattia playing sizable minutes, especially down the stretch.
Yeah, Mattia really did a good job again. I mean, he really just made the one shot, but he made it when we needed it. And I thought his defense was good. I thought he did a pretty good job defensively, Mattia. He was playing a fifth-year senior, and I thought he pretty much did a good job, pretty much head-to-head on him. So, but then, of course, Rock. I mean, you know, Justin getting 26 points. I don't know if there's a way to, you know, how would you compare, if there's a formula for it, 18 rebounds? That's got to be like getting 36 points, right? Like, what would you, if you were to compare points and rebounds, right? I mean, that's a lot of rebounds, 18 points. That's got to be like getting 36 points. That's an amazing, incredible thing.
Joe, you talked about there's no gimmies in college basketball. Tonight, Drexel, which was winless, beat Charleston in overtime.
Talked about it.
Hard to get right. Like, what's, I mean, it's only 3 games into the season, but it already seems like everything's kind of chaotic in the league. What do you say to the guys, you know, tonight or Saturday?
Jerry, we talked about it. I mean, right in there. I brought it right up. I said, we talked about how hard it is to win a college basketball game, and then I use those examples. I mean, you know, geez, they just, you know, it's the perfect example. We could have got bumped tonight, and we wouldn't let it happen. And if you're not ready to go, I don't care who you're playing, Drexel, James Madison, College of Charleston, if you're not ready to go, you're not going to win. You're not going to win.
Joe, is the team able to build up sort of momentum, like, from, you know, pulling out these games? You know, you look at Monmouth, you look at making the shot today. Can you build on that? And, you know, in contrast to last year where it sort of kind of snowballed downhill for you guys.
You should. Yeah. You should build on it. You hope you're going to build on it. Why not? I mean, but am I 100% certain that we will? We talk about it. But it's about, you know, embracing it, understanding what a great win this is, and making it, you know, making yourself hungry for more. There's two things you deal with in life, success and failure. If you're successful, you should want more success. And if you fail, you should not want to fail. It's pretty obvious. But hopefully our guys are going to want more of this success and be hungry for it.
So what is it about GMU? You always tends to get you to play their pace. You know, I mean, I have some time with overtime, but you know, that first half especially, they really seem to bring you slow down. What is it about them that makes them so successful? Kind of making you guys maybe a little bit out of your element.
You know, I'm not sure. I'm going to take the blame for that. I'm not sure I had us in the right offensive scheme. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not sure we were doing the right things. I mean, I thought we'd be able to. We set a lot of ball screens in the first half. We didn't handle them well. Our ball screen offense was terrible. You know, I'm going to take the blame for that. We probably should have been doing some other things that we did in the second half and so forth. So, but I think it was their defense. I mean, our offense was just inept. Yeah, it's my fault.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.